Water pressure regulators, or PRVs, are essential components of many plumbing systems. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly what PRVs do and how they work. You may ask, why should I care about a pressure regulator? You may have one of these near your water meter. They're used to lower the pressure of the water supplied from your city to a level safe enough that the water lines and fixtures in your home are not damaged by high water pressure. All right, let's take a look at a typical water pressure regulator. We'll look very quickly at the main parts of the PRV, then we'll look at what each part does. Here's the inlet port where high pressure water enters, and the outlet port where reduced pressure water exits. The diaphragm is the heart of the regulator. It's a flexible membrane that moves up and down in response to pressure changes, adjusting the valve to regulate water flow. The diaphragm is basically what senses pressure and makes changes to adjust the pressure. Above the diaphragm is the adjusting screw. Turning the screw compresses or looses the spring beneath it. The tighter the spring, the more force it exerts on the diaphragm, increasing the pressure required to move the diaphragm and close the valve. Below the diaphragm, we have the valve stem and the poppet valve or disc. These components control flow by opening or closing the gap where pressure reduction occurs. Then there's a spring that helps to close the poppet valve. And lastly, we have a cap on top of the regulator. Here's a quick look at how the valve operates. As the diaphragm moves, it adjusts the position of the poppet valve, opening or closing the gap to control water flow and regulate pressure. The gap between the poppet valve and its seat is where the pressure reduction happens. As water flows through this restricted opening, the pressure drops. Think of it like a resistor in an electrical circuit. Just as a resistor reduces the flow of electricity or current, the gap reduces water pressure by restricting the amount of water flowing through it. The size of this gap directly affects the outlet pressure. When the gap widens, there is a smaller pressure drop, so the outlet pressure increases. When the gap narrows, there's a larger pressure drop and the outlet pressure decreases. You can adjust the pressure that the PRV is providing by adjusting the set screw on top. Turning the screw clockwise will compress or tighten the screw. As a result, a higher pressure will now be required to overcome the force of the spring. This obviously results in the outlet pressure increasing. On the other hand, loosening the screw will decrease the outlet pressure. Let's look a little closer at how the valve operates. When water flows through the valve, the diaphragm and spring continuously adjust the poppet valve's position to maintain a consistent outlet pressure. This constant interaction and reaction to flow and inlet pressure changes is what keeps the water pressure essentially constant. Now let's look at what happens when the inlet pressure suddenly increases. Here the inlet pressure suddenly jumps from 85 psi to 110 psi. Note, in reality this happens instantly, but I'm showing it step by step to make it easier to follow. This higher pressure pushes against the diaphragm with more force. This causes the diaphragm to move upward slightly. As the diaphragm moves upward, it allows the poppet valve to close slightly. This restricts the flow of water, preventing the outlet pressure from rising significantly. As a result, the regulator restores the outlet pressure to its original setting of 50 psi almost instantaneously. Now that you've seen this work in super slow motion, let's watch a similar situation, a little more real time, but still slowed down some. You'll see a pressure regulator with water flowing through at a constant flow and pressure. Suddenly, the inlet pressure goes up. This causes the outlet pressure to also go up some. This higher pressure causes the diaphragm to be pushed up, closing the valve partially. This in turn causes the outlet pressure to return to the desired level. A similar thing happens if the inlet pressure suddenly drops. You can see that here. Now let's look at another scenario that happens hundreds of times per day. Water is flowing through the PRV and the faucet in the house is suddenly turned off. Let's watch how the pressure regulator reacts to this. As water stops flowing, there will be an immediate increase in pressure on the outlet side of the valve. That higher pressure will quickly overcome the pressure of the adjusting spring and will push the diaphragm up. This will cause the poppet valve to close, basically locking in the lower pressure on the house side of the valve. As long as there is no demand for water to the home, in other words, if there's no water flowing, then the poppet valve must be closed. Let's take a quick look at why. This shows what would happen if there's no flow, but if the valve remained open. If this were the case in reality, then the water pressure in the home would be the same as on the inlet side of the PRV, because with no flow, there's no pressure drop across that gap. So that's basically it. This is how a pressure regulator works to maintain a steady pressure to our homes. It's a simple but ingenious device designed to help protect our home's plumbing systems. Not all homes have these, but many do. So now you know how they work. I hope you've learned something by watching this video. I really appreciate you watching. I sure would appreciate a thumbs up. If you enjoy videos like this, please subscribe to my channel so you'll be notified when new videos are available. Thanks again. Have a great day.